direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop, it's HCTV News.
Welcome back to another edition of Cheney Tech's very own HCTV News.
That's right, I'm Camfield Heinrich.
And I'm Morgan Landry.
Every morning, Cheney Tech is informed about the daily and weekly announcements of interest to the Cheney community. Our morning announcements have changed over the past year, don't you think, Morgan?
I agree, Camfield. Junior Kyle Isla provided us with information on the new announcement format.
As 2016 begins, there are already new changes at Cheney. The morning announcements, once read by Mrs. Jackson on the PA system, have already been changed twice in this new year. The first change the announcements went through was that homeroom teachers started to read the slides posted on the Cheney Tech main page. This was a better idea, according to Mrs. Jackson, who says personalizing announcements in a smaller setting allows for the students to see the slides, not just hear the announcements, and ask questions as needed. While doing it this way, it helps students to connect more to the announcements. They have changed again. Now morning announcements are shown on the board in homeroom and also read out loud over the PA system by Mrs. Jackson. Mrs. Jackson is open to any suggestions to improve the announcements if you have any. Well, that was quite enlightening. Now that students can see and hear the announcements at the same time, they are likely to pay more attention than before.
Hey, Camfield, have you ever wondered why we don't have cheerleading anymore here at Cheney?
Nope.
Well, I and others have wondered why this sport is not at our school anymore. Junior Taylor Rinaldi had the same question, and the result was the following story.
Cheney Tech is a part of the Connecticut Interscholastic Athletic Conference. Unlike most state high schools, we do not have cheerleading as a sport here.
We have about 200 high schools that belong to the CIAC, and almost every single one does have a cheerleading program.
I think it would be great to have one. I think it helps out in school spirit. It gets more people to the games. They'll be more energized during the breaks, and also it gets other athletes or people that want to have an interest in cheer get an opportunity to do it in the school.
Our school used to have a cheerleading team starting from the late 80s to the early 2000s. According to our athletic director, Mr. Sylvia, we stopped having a cheer team due to the lack of girls wanting to join. Many people would enjoy having a cheer team and the school spirit it supports that comes from it.
Our players would definitely value from having a cheer team, and it gets them psyched up in the downtime or definitely during halftime. But I think the fans, and they'll bring the students out to see the game. It'll be a great opportunity for us if we had one.
According to the CIAC, to start a cheerleading team or squad, this is what you need to do.
Students would get together and decide they had some interest. They would probably approach their athletic director first, let he or she know that they were interested, and then the athletic director could approach the administration of the school to find out if there were resources available.
Cheney would not need a large team like the ones that compete. We're here to support our teams and to cheer them on. So according to Ms. Niehoff, a coach would be able to start a team with no less than 6 members. For HCTV News, I am Taylor Rinaldi.
Wow, she really did her research.
It's great to see people passionate for the things they're interested in.
I hope students will get inspired to start their own club or team that supports their interests.
Absolutely.
What else has been going on in the world of Cheney Tech? Anything specific to us in digital media that you'd like to touch on?
Sure. The DMV PSA contest was something that we had a lot of fun with in shop. The annual Safe Teen Driving Contest is sponsored by the Connecticut Department of Motor Vehicles. Contest entries portray both what not to do and what to do while driving.
Let's take a look at the first of 3 entries. This one is called Entitled Friends.
I was so confused. And then, dude, stop! You drive like a maniac.
Says one not even wearing a seatbelt.
I tell you this all the time. When shifting in the drive, keep the safety of others in mind. You never listen to me, do you?
Fine, I'll drive your way. See how that works.
That was a very good spot. Props to the seniors who created the video. Our next story is about the school social worker, Mrs. Cortez. Do you know what a social worker is, Morgan?
I have a rough idea, yes. And yourself?
I don't know. Junior Dylan Tripp has a story.
Social workers are professionals whose primary goal is to help people in need. Social workers also focus on addressing social problems and social injustices. The school social worker, I focus on promoting the emotional competencies of students and linking families, schools, and community together. My main goal is to help the students be successful in school although they might find themselves in difficult situations in school or outside of school. Each student and each situation is different, so there's no set way of helping students. Some students need weekly monitoring. Some students benefit from group work. In some cases, as a school social worker, I work together with the student, the family, the school community, and outside of school providers in order to ensure that the student is successful in school. Bring guests and speakers into the school that speak on bigger issues such as substance abuse, health and safety issues. The newsletters are meant for the parents. They're called the Cheney Tech Parents Newsletter, and I write them every quarter, after each quarter. And it's a way for me to communicate with the parents and provide tools for the parents that will help them help their child in school as well.
Thanks to Dylan Tripp for teaching or reinforcing our understanding of social workers and their jobs.
I sure learned a lot from that piece.
Ms. Cortez helps those that are in need and makes sure that the school is a safe, socially acceptable environment for everyone through supporting a positive climate.
Speaking of helping those in need, let's take a look at our second DMV contest entry.
Nice segue, Campfield.
Thanks. This spot was done by a duo of juniors, Kiara Franklin and Taylor Rinaldi.
My name is Ashley. I made some big mistakes that caused me to lose my best friends forever.
You killed me.
We didn't wear seatbelts. I didn't tell him to.
You killed me.
I got in the car under the influence.
You killed me.
And I just wouldn't put my phone down. I'm so sorry. It's all my fault.
When shifting into drive, keep the safety of others in mind.
Wow, that was a very emotional spot. They did a very good job.
I agree. Now moving on. Have you heard any new music you like lately? I heard 21 Pilots' album is all right.
You mean Blurry Face?
Yeah, have you heard it?
Not yet.
Well, lucky for you, senior Josue Cardona has a review of the album.
Sometimes you gotta bleed and know that you're alive and have a soul.
Tear in My Heart is one of the songs in Blurry Face, 21 Pilots' new album that was released May 17th in 2015. The album is composed of 14 songs. It is the fourth studio album by 21 Pilots, which was set to be released on May 19th, 2015 through their label, Fueled by Ramen. However, the album debuted by the band 2 days earlier on iTunes. All the songs in the album are new except for Goner, which is originally uploaded to YouTube in 2012 by 21 Pilots themselves.
I'm a goner. Somebody catch my breath. I'm a goner. Somebody catch my breath.
Back in May, Blurry Face claimed the number one spot on the Billboard 200 chart. Within the first week of the album's debut, 134,000 copies were sold in the first week alone. To the present, Blurry Face is number 20 on the iTunes Top 100 albums. On Spotify, 21 Pilots' most popular songs are Stressed Out, Tear in My Heart, Ride, Heavy Dirty Soul, and Car Radio. Four of the top five songs are from the new album. In order of popularity, it goes Stressed Out with 54,555,223 plays, Car Radio with 38,188,045 plays, Tear in My Heart with 36,632,462 plays, Ride with 25,662,641 plays, and Heavy Dirty Soul with 17,528,765 plays. The album is called Blurry Face for a reason. Blurry Face is a fictional character that anyone can relate to. In the album, Blurry Face is someone's insecurities. For Tyler, those insecurities are what he creates with his hands. That's why he has the black paint on his hands and throat. So in music videos such as Tear in My Heart, the character Blurry Face gives a feeling of suffocation. Throughout the video, his surroundings are being destroyed and everyone is judging him. Those feelings are depicted by everyone's eyes being dilated, and one of the verses Tyler sings, "Sometimes you gotta bleed to know that you're alive and have a soul, but it takes someone to come around to show you how."
Sometimes you gotta bleed to know, oh, oh, that you're alive and have a soul, oh, oh. But it takes someone to come around to show you how she's been tearing my heart.
I mean, sometimes you have to feel pain to know that you're alive and real. This is portrayed in the music video by a woman coming along who's actually Tyler's wife in real life. In the music video, unlike everyone else, her eyes do not get dilated and she begins to beat up Tyler.
I'm alive, she's the tear in my heart. I'm on fire, she's the tear in my heart. Take me higher than
the... He's actually fighting Blurryface and she's trying to help him. She loves Tyler, but she's going to be real with him even if it hurts. It's truly a beautiful relationship. His relationship with his wife is more real than any other relationship he's experienced before, and it's taken him to a deeper, better place in life.
She's the tear in my heart. She's a carver. She's a butcher with a smile. Cut me farther than I've ever been.
So Blurryface isn't just an album that's gained 21 Pilots a lot of attention. It is also a character that Tyler created to assist him in expressing himself through his music. Altogether, Blurryface is a great album, and you should check it out on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, and other platforms.
Think I'll check him out on Spotify when I get home.
Good. Here is the last entry for this year's DMV contest, created by Kyle Islip and myself.
Come on, Morgan, let's go get something to eat.
Can you even drive?
Yeah, it's easy.
All right, I guess.
So are you ready?
No, not until you put your seatbelt on.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry.
No.
What?
No, I can't do this. What about my safety? You only have your permit.
Okay, I don't want to hurt you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be such a dummy.
Our shop is all about video productions, so it's safe to say that many of us in digital media are fans of movie making.
Yep, movie buff or not, anyone can enjoy a good movie.
With that said, we are excited to introduce to HGTV News, the first of a series of movie reviews. Here's Sierra Rosa with the review of The Revenant.
Welcome to the first ever media review, where we'll be talking about some highly reviewed movies and previewing upcoming 2016 movies.
Some from critically acclaimed critic websites and newspapers.
There is so much to like and admire and study closely, including DiCaprio's mature, committed, ruthless, and yet empathetic performance. Bruce Kirkland from Toronto Sun.
Only safe thing to do is track a new course back up online.
Walk on out. I'm talking to you.
Punishing, visceral, masculine, grisly, and utterly captivating for its runtime. Not for everyone, but it's a powerful trip if your mind and spirit can endure it. Sean O'Connell from Cinema Blend.
While exploring the uncharted wilderness in 1823, legendary frontiersman Hugh Glass, played by Leonardo DiCaprio, sustains injuries from a brutal bear attack. When his hunting team leaves him for a day, Glass must utilize his survival skills to find a way back home to his beloved family. Grief-stricken and fueled by vengeance, Glass treks to the wintry terrain to track down John Fitzgerald, played by Tom Hardy, the former confidant who betrayed and abandoned him.
He's to be cared for as long as necessary.
I understand.
Help!
What happened?
We did what we had to do.
He was buried right.
All I had was my boy. And he took him from me, you understand? How far I came to find them.
Rotten Tomatoes, a review site where many critics and movie fanatics rave about the movies they saw or deem it rotten, meaning they disliked the movie, while others can deem it fresh, meaning they liked the movie.
I ain't afraid to die anymore.
Revenant got a rating of 82% on the tomato meter, accompanied by 257 reviews, and out of those, 212 were fresh and 45 rotten. With an audience score of 86%, it's clear that they loved the movie.
That's all we have for now. Tune in next time for more updates and reviews.
An Oscar-winning performance by Leonardo DiCaprio.
Great acting, and if you saw the Oscars, it was a great acceptance speech as well.
Don't forget to let us know in the comments below what your thoughts on the new movie review series.
We have one more story before we wrap everything up.
Here's a Cheney Tech baseball story by sophomore Matt Motika.
I'm Ken Leggo. I'm the head baseball coach, varsity level, at Cheney Tech. Very excited. Always wanted a head coaching position in baseball at a high school level. And watching the program grow and having it be an established program, you can't be anything but excited at the chance to take it over.
Making the transition from coaching softball to baseball was a very tough decision, but being a baseball person, he loved the opportunity to become the head coach.
The preparation started right when the season ended last year, not even knowing that a head coaching position would be open. You look for what's coming up. You look for what you have, player-wise, skill-wise, what you're hoping to get, who you're losing, and you plan a strategy. You come up with a game plan, and of course that's changed at least 20, 30 times already, and I'm sure it will. But we are right now just trying to get our pitchers' arms, have them keep throwing through the winter, having people play other sports, or at least condition during the winter, so that when spring hits, we're ready to roll.
Preparing during the offseason is one thing, but losing seniors that play key roles in your team's success is definitely going to affect the teams to come. Coach Leggo is also excited to see who is going to step up and take the missing positions.
You hear, and in baseball especially, stepping up to the plate. Now is the opportunity for some of these players that are returning and new to step up to the plate. I see it as a great thing because they saw a group of seniors that could play baseball, okay, and played it well. Now it's their turn to duplicate that and even make it better. So, miss them, yeah. Excited about who's going to step up and take the positions? Absolutely.
In addition to new leaders, a new assistant coach will be beneficial to the mending of the team.
I want a pitcher with the team holding four fingers in the air.
With that, we come to an end of this episode, but don't worry, we'll be back soon.
If you want to make sure to not miss any future editions of HCTV News or any other content we produce, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube page.
Liking and sharing the video helps a lot, so if you like what you see, make sure you do so.
From all of us here in digital media, we thank you for watching. I'm Canfield Heinrich.
And I'm Morgan Landry, signing off for HCTV News.